Dubai with Santhosh,
yes.
You all actually, you know, you wanted to break away from the Sri Lankan market and go global. Where are you aiming now?
So basically right now, Mahesh, just to tell you a little bit of a history of our industry and what she was talking about as well. So entrepreneurship was one part of our you know, our success as well. So when we came into the industry, most of the time, people who sang or did whatever arts were just the artist. So then what we realized was that at one point, now, if you take the, like say about 30 years ago, if you take a telephone, if you want to get a phone, you have to wait for 5 years or 4 years in a waiting line. And then if you wanted to go and do a transaction at a bank, you had to go to that bank, they had to fax, do all that, there were no ATM machines. But those industries, by the time that we came into the industry during 1998, they had structured themselves in such a way that they were technically, they were being formed as proper industries. And in that analysis, what we found was that the people who do the core part of that particular subject is about 5%.
Mm.
It is the others who come and they are the ones who rev up the industry, like people, HR, marketing, all this. Now, if you take a telecommunication company right now, the biggest ones, how many people are telecommunication engineers there?
Yeah.
maybe a few hundred people, but then it's the others, right, who come and then they propel the industry to that massive exponential growth. So we realized that in entertainment, I'm not talking, now when I say entertainment, a lot of people think that media and entertainment are the same. No, media is media.
Yeah, media is media.
Right? Media had exponential growth during the late 90s and the early 2000s, and media was set up. But entertainment was still scattered around, right? So what we thought was, why can't we make this into a corporate structure? So that is where we started off. So what we did was, we started off with small, you know, we started off with the audio business, and then we expanded into a few audio studios, and then we quite realized that having the Bharti and Santhosh tag on it didn't bring us enough business to sustain this and start growing it. So we called it a different brand name, and we started getting other engineers. We started employing them on a full time. Then we wanted to do those big shows and big
productions.
And then what we quite realized was that we had event companies at that time, but then the passion of doing this, they operated like a business. They were not solving a problem. So we got a lot of problem solvers from campuses, from universities, and then we started this small company called Showtown, and now it has become what you guys know today.
Yeah.
So we started building around this. And then towards 2010, we quite realized that people from banking, like people if I may say names, like banks like HSBC, like global banks, and to NTB, all these banks, right? We got guys coming and saying, you know, look, we want to quit our bank job and come into this because we want to do entertainment as a fan. So then, okay, where are we going to fit them? Then we started our own client servicing teams. And so this went on, and now we are like eight companies. We have got a massive staff, and now we are operating under a proper structure. So this is our goal. But during this, now since we are talking about the Great Reset, one thing that I must sadly say is that while doing our operation, one thing that we saw was even the big corporates in Sri Lanka, except for a few companies like maybe MS or what Linda was talking about, they all focused on vertical growth. So when you focus on vertical growth, you're looking at shooting out of the country. But most of our big corporates, you see what they're doing. They grow vertically, and suddenly when they come to the shores of Sri Lanka, they start going horizontally. And they eat into each other's markets, and then the markets become saturated, and then we are in the same mess again. Only a few companies, like the apparel, like what Linda said, only a few companies have thought of growing vertically and going out of the shores. But all the others are like, they come like this and become a T at the end of the day. And then they stop at our shows. And so even us at the moment, like I think that, you know, we pass that first cycle. So every company, I'm sure, every operation, you start small and then you have like leaps. it happens in time periods. You don't grow like this. Mm. You do grow like this, but then suddenly you have a skew up, and then again you grow like that and skew. So now we are like right now in our fourth, we are searching for our fourth skew, like a big upward skew there. So like what Linda was saying, we are right now looking at a major vertical skew, not a horizontal growth
that
at the moment.
That means to hit the highest
we
mark.
Want to hit that. Now, with this girl's success, Johanny's success, what we have been talking to most of the other entertainers and the entertainment companies are, let's try to get that model into the entire business environment that we operate in. And let's try to talk to her, talk to her collaborators, and let's try to now get this gate opened up further. Because to come to this gate, we had to fight a few battles over the last 20 years.